In this spreadsheet, we are going to calculate the shipping cost based on the shipment option and the number of books shipped. If the number of books shipped is between 1 and 9 and the shipping option is standard, your shipping cost will be 99 cents. If the number of books shipped is between 10 and 19 and the shipping option is standard, the cost will be $3. If the number of books that are being shipped is greater than or equal to 20 and it's standard shipping, it will be free. If you're using 2-day shipping and the number of books is between 1 and 9, the cost will be $1.99. If you're using 2-day shipment option and the number of books is between 10 and 19, it will cost you $10.99 to ship the books, and so forth. The VLookup function will be used to obtain the shipping cost. The lookup value will be the shipment option. Our list will be A3 to D5. When we copy this down, we don't want our list range to change. We will put dollar signs in front of the numbers. The column index number to use is based on the number of books, so we will use the if function as this third argument. If the number of books is less than 10, we will return the second column, 1, 2. If the number of books is less than 20, we will return the third column, 1, 2, 3. Otherwise, we will return the fourth column. Excuse me, we need 3 here, and then we need 4. We have 2 if functions, so we need 2 ending parentheses. And we need an exact match on our shipment option, so we need a false. The third argument in the lookup function is the column index number. The column index number is based on the number of books. So in this argument, the third argument, instead of just putting a column index number, we are going to need to use the if function to determine that. So if the number of books is between 1 and 9, which means it's less than 10, we will display the value in the second column, 1, 2. If the number of books is between 10 and 19, which means it's less than 20, we will display the value in the third column, 1, 2, 3. Otherwise, we will display the value in the fourth column. We have 2 if functions, so we need to end both of them with parentheses. Because the initial lookup is looking for the shipping option, we need an exact match, so we put in false. Because we're copying this down, we have our range with the dollar signs, but we also need dollar signs in front of the 2 in the C and the 2 in the D, because when we copy them down, we do not want those to change or the values to change. So we have to keep those cell references. And there are answers. In this worksheet, the shipping cost will either be per item or per shipment, depending on which is cheaper. If the shipping cost per book is greater than the shipping cost per shipment, then we will use the shipment cost. Otherwise, we will use the per item shipping cost. In this case, we will start with an if function. The first thing I'm going to do is find the shipping cost per book. So I will use a lookup function to find that. The shipment option is standard. The range is going to be A3 to B5, comma. I'm going to return the second column. I want to return an exact value. That will give me the per item cost, but this is going to be by the book, by the number of books. So I have to multiply it by the number of books. I need to check if the shipping cost per book times the number of books is greater than the shipping cost just by shipment. So I'll use another VLookup. I'm going to check for the shipment option. My range this time will be A3 to C5. I'm going to return the third column. I need an exact match, so I'm using the last argument of false. So if the shipping cost per book is greater than the shipping cost per shipment, then I am going to use the shipping cost per shipment. So I need a VLookup again. Again, I'm going to use the shipment option. And I put a 9 there instead of a parenthesis. I'm going to use the shipment option. I'm going to use the range A3 to C5. I'm going to return the third column, and that's an exact match for the shipping option. And then otherwise, I am going to use the shipping option of the number of books by the dollar amount per item. So I need to check for the shipment option again. My range is A3 to B5. I'm returning the second column. Again, I have an exact match. And this time I'm multiplying it by the number of books. I have one if statement. So the if statement will end with a parenthesis. There's my answer. I need to anchor in these ranges. I can copy this down, and there are my answers. In this spreadsheet, I have a list of properties, and I have the current rent. Above, I have a proposed rental increase. If the property's rent is less than $700, then the rate increase will be 7%. If the current rent is greater than or equal to $700 but less than $1,000, the increase will be 5%. If the current rent is $1,000 or more, the increase will be 3%. I have my list in a horizontal row, so I'm going to need to use the lookup, HLookup. I'm checking for the current rent. My range is B2 to D3. I'm going to return the second row. I'm looking for a range, so I'm using the true. I'm multiplying it by the current rent to get the percentage, and then adding the current rent to get the actual increase. I'm copying this down, so I need to put a dollar sign in front of the numbers in the range. And there are my answers.